I'm in Canada, not in a kitchen, and I'm here with Frank, who is essentially one of the most experienced people in Algonquin Park. And today, we've just been out on the boats, we've just caught the freshest fish I think I'm ever going to eat in my life. Tell me your perfect day in Algonquin Park.
Catching lots of fish, favoured.
What do you think it is that makes this place so magical?
I don't know how to explain it, really. Every time I look at it, I mean, it makes you wonder is what makes it, you know? It's so peaceful.
It's lovely, isn't it? I love this already. Oh, no, no. Oh.
You're whipping it too hard, like.
Oh. You didn't see that. That didn't happen.
There you go. See?
That's very satisfying. You don't have any fear of this place at all, do
no.
you?
Oh, I've come face to face with a bear, but they back down because I show no fear.
That's a proper wild man talking. We've got one! Hey! That's not bad. Fantastic. Look at that. Is there still parts of it that you've yet to explore?
Oh, I know every lake in Algonquin Park. I don't follow maps. Map is up here.
I think we've got plenty of fish.
I'm going to cook you up some beans. Fish, you have cucumber, tomato, chips, bread.
And the vegetables, the tomato and the cucumber, have come straight from your garden?
Come straight from my garden.
I'm so excited.
I picked this with a flashlight this morning.
Fantastic. So I'm not going to be cooking an awful lot in this episode, which again, we're just breaking all the rules of a Katie Picks video. I've been told that I can't because I'm not going to do it as well as Frank. Is that fair?
That's right. Well, you probably could if you had my seasoning.
Wait, is there a secret seasoning?
That secret seasoning mixed in my flour.
And you're not going to tell us what that is?
No. The only one that's going to know about it is my daughter after I pass away.
You've prepped it, cut it into strips, and then we're going... Oh, wait, okay. Can I feed him?
Yeah.
Come up. Do you want it? No. We'll take that. This is the best experience ever.
This is what you call shake and bake. Flour mixed with, I got cornmeal in it too.
So you get that little bit of crunch?
Yeah.
Love that. So you've been guiding here for how long?
74
years. Oh, you don't like the crisps anymore? We've got fussy chipmunk. Oh, going golden. That's beautiful.
It always tastes better out in the bush.
That's applewood though, isn't it?
Apple and hickory.
Made yourself?
Yeah, I smoke 10, 12 pounds of it every year.
Oh, genuinely made yourself?
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's awesome.
Why don't you go over there and start getting yourself a plate before it cools down?
I mean, don't have to tell me twice. Can I stay here?
Yeah. Grab yourself a slice of bread if you want.
You pre-buttered the bread.
Yeah, the bread's buttered.
Cucumber, tomato, a bit more. I can go more, right?
Oh, yeah. And a fish.
Yes.
You never get your mouth open big enough for that.
You'd be surprised, Frank. You'd be surprised. So how long have you been developing this recipe for?
Oh, I don't know. 40 years, 50 years.
This is magic. This is proper magic.
Here's my lunch right there. The rest is yours, Steve.
Challenge accepted. Ready?
Enjoy.
Oh, I will. Frank, that's pretty special. We've gone out, we've caught it, we've cooked it. Thank you. This is awesome. I will never forget this. The fish is so flaky and light and delicate and sweet. What is in that?
There's 17 different spices in that.
This has been unforgettable. As if this place wasn't crazy enough. Thank you so much, Frank, for joining me. Thank you guys for watching. If you want an experience like this, or you want to see what I've been up to in Canada, then make sure you click all of those links in the description box, please. Thank you. You won't regret it. I won't forget it. As if this is actually happening.
You want, you can take the rest of it home.
And actually, I'm going to take it to a scientist to work out what the 17 ingredients are. Thanks for watching.